David Herman, and I'm working on the daily sketch. Today's daily sketch on January 12, 2017, is a Sumai Japanese-style Siamese cat. And I've been playing with the brush, and because these are 10-minute videos, I opted to do a little bit of this drawing before I begin with you guys. So what I've done is I've set up a brush so that it has a wet function in Photoshop. And now what I'm doing is painting as though it was an ink, a water ink, like a Sumai brush. I'm using just black and white. So I'm going to switch these paints. So I'm taking it off with some white here to get the look of actually painting it with like a paintbrush that was dipped in water and ink and blending it. And it's been working really well. You can see a soft effect that I get. I'm not sure exactly how this painting's going, but we're starting now a few minutes into this thing, about 8 or 10 minutes into it, instead of just jumping in. And this machine would, my recording device, which is timed for 10 minutes, would just cut you off. So you get to see what I've done here. And this is totally an option in Photoshop. It's under the wet brush. So you go to your brushes here, right below the eyedropper, you go to your brushes. You have your brush tool, that's for your airbrush, your pencil, your color replacement tool, and then a mixer brush. The mixer brush has a little water drop on it. So that's your wet brush. And then up here you have your parameters at the top where it says wet, load, mix, and flow. So figure flow is like your pressure. And mix is how much water you have to ink. So I have right now at 36%. Your load, how much ink is in there, I'm putting 60%. And how wet it is, I have 60%. And so far, I've gotten this far. And right now I have it set on white. You can see I'm erasing some of the extraneous lines that I don't want in my picture. It doesn't matter that they're in there because I can always take them out. And now I go back to black just by switching, toggling back and forth here. And I can fill in, see? So the way I've set the brush up, you can draw very light like this. This is very little pressure on my tablet. Or you can put more pressure on, see, and you get a dark, dark black, dense black. And it also has that very soft edge, different than an airbrush, where it looks like a paintbrush. And so now if we go to white for a moment, we can take this out. And you see, because I don't have that at 100%, it's sort of a blended look, right? Like we're smearing paint around. But we're just going to take that out like this for now. I kind of like the grayness in it and the off-white look, so that's cool with me. Now, I wanted to add a point to this tail. So if I do, I can take it out by the white. We're bringing it down a little bit. Take that off. The super long tail. And then sharpen that up a little bit. Take a little more out of here so it tapers in, you know, gets wider at the base, narrower at the top. And then I'm going to switch to black. I'm going to apply more pressure, and I'm going to sharpen that point up, hopefully. So let's see what happens here. You get a nice kind of a point to a cat's tail. And then just kind of back in there, blend back in, see? And if I want another foot, say, sticking out like here, like it's resting, I might widen my brush a little bit. Now I'm in the black. And so here I can just kind of outline where I'd want a foot, say like here, and then put some pressure on And now it's starting to darken. And I can kind of shape the toe like that. And if it starts to get into the body of the cat, then I can switch to the white and take that out. See, even here I've got like a little gray tone you can see in the body itself. And this white's taking that out of there. And now this is pushed into this. No big deal. You switch back to your black. You could add stroke there. You could shape this knee of your cat into here, you know. If you wanted more musculature showing and stuff like that, you could add that. If I want to really stretch these neck muscles gently, so that you see a little bit of his turn, a little more like so, can do that. And then we can take the white and we can soften that accordingly. Maybe, you know, just not too harsh, not too light. Get rid of some of these dumb lines. They're not dumb, but I mean, they don't belong there. There's just, I don't want to use words that affect you PC wise. They're dumb. I put them in, they don't belong there. Never mind my speech. And so sometimes there's like a muscle that puffs up or a shoulder that puffs up here. Let's go back to the black. Let's kind of have that puffing out a little. Remember, this could cut off, so excuse me if it does. But I'm very happy with what we're showing now, because you get to see something. This is 20 minutes into it, to be honest. And it would not have given you much to see. You would have seen where I started and not where we're going to end together as a group in this. And so let's get some white back here. And we're going to, back to the white. Take some of this out, the vertical. The paw is cool. I just don't want it to be gigantic. And, you know, I'm just doing this from mind here, so. It's always cool to do stuff like that. You can make your brush so small that you can kind of get into these spots like this gently and retain the border, the outside edge. You can play with this ad infinitum, you know. And so far that looks pretty interesting as a soft Japanese style drawing. Now we probably would want whiskers on our cat. So let's add some whiskers. Let's put a couple high ones up in the eye, like you'd see. Maybe a couple in the mouth and the muscles of the, like so. Look at that. Isn't that something? So it, you know, my daily sketches is going to teach me many different things to be working on. And I'll be darned. There's so much to learn that it's way cool. And it's doable. And that ear might be just a touch tall in the background. So let's go back. And let's open up our brush. See that? And let's just stubby that up a little bit. Shorten it. So we have the perspective effect. You know, we don't want them both the same height. And this looks a little too rigid, so I'll take that down. Man, nice feel for something that's mechanical, because it doesn't feel mechanical at all. If I had framed this or something and told you I did it with a brush, you probably would think it was done with a brush. And wow, that's looking very, very interesting. So I want to add some white down in here to bring this out ahead, you know, like it's in front of. I'm not, you know, I don't like them all on the same plane like that. So the neck is torqued and twisted from the front being over here turning to the back. And we would have some evidence of that by the shape of this. And look at that. Boy, that is just...